What's up, High Tides? I'm Jed Hoffman of Beat Film News. That was a pretty cool intro, right? It's new! I'd like to also welcome you back to the first Beat Film News of the 2021 to 2022 school year, where we're all back together physical. Now, because we're physical, we do have to wear our masks. Here's a segment about that.
Carvalho told us today he plans to recommend that the school board approve a mask mandate in Miami-Dade with some accommodations.
Governor Ron DeSantis mentioned two Florida counties failing to abide by his executive order at today's news conference.
I just want my daughter's face to be seen by her teachers.
I honestly would have given anything for a mask.
Maybe the reason why we have people in the hospitals, all this mask wearing. Do we ever think of that?
He just signed an executive order which says under Florida's Parents' Bill of Rights, the parents should be the ones to decide whether they want their kid to wear a mask in school.
So what is your opinion on the mask mandate?
I don't have a negative opinion on it. It's for the best interest of all the students that are on the mask.
They protect you from getting sick, but they suck.
I definitely think it helps a lot with stopping the spread, especially because everyone I see has actually been doing it, as opposed to just kind of not abiding.
It's definitely a good decision on behalf of our superintendent.
I mean, it's good because, like, it's
I don't know, it's pretty useful to prevent corona.
Thanks.
The mask mandate is very good because it will stop the spread of COVID throughout the school, which is very important because COVID is a disastrous disease that has harmed the lives of many.
I think that we all need to wear them, and we must remember to cover our noses with them.
Wearing a mask is annoying. However, it's only a little bit annoying. And what can happen to other people when you're not wearing a mask could be disastrously bad.
Okay, is there anything in particular that you miss about seeing people's faces?
No.
I think being able to recognize people from afar.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, I miss seeing people's smiles mostly. The most beautiful part, like, in general of anyone is a smile. And so, like, not seeing them anymore as often, I'm just like, oh.
I miss people being able to see when I smile and when I'm laughing or making facial expressions at them in class.
Yeah, I like seeing people's faces, but this is worth it. I like this better.
I like to see their facial expressions to see if they're actually like engaged if I'm talking to them. So, and also just seeing people's faces. Like, I just like to see people's faces, I guess. Not in a weird way.
I do definitely miss seeing people's faces, but what can we do?
It's always weird to watch someone smile with a face mask on because like it just looks like they're in pain and parts of their body are wincing. So you really miss some of the smiling, but you get parts of it. And you do miss seeing people's face, and we all want to see everyone's face again. You never really realize how much you miss something until it's gone.
Yes, I miss seeing people's faces, namely Miss Pierce, because she has the most gorgeous smile and beautiful eyes, and I'm in love with her. I love Miss Pierce.
What do you think are some of the ultimate pros for masks?
Keeping everyone safe. We don't want to spread COVID. We want everyone to be healthy. We want everyone to be happy here at school. So I think ultimately wearing masks is the best thing.
They help out so much whenever I'm like, okay, I don't want to talk, but I kind of have to, so I'm just like, okay. Everything is hidden in the mask. I'm fine. I usually only like break out here, so I'm just like, okay, bet. I can cover this and I'll be fine.
So when I was young, really young, I always wanted to go to school as a ninja. And I think that everyone finally got the chance to be able to pull that off.
One good thing about the mask is that you can like lip sync to music.
Oh, yes, I always do.
The pros, keeping everyone safe.
Express your individuality.
Yeah, I'm wearing a black mask, but like you can do all sorts of things.
It's a fashion statement.
If you get nervous and embarrassed, then maybe it won't be shown through your mask. Sometimes breath smells bad. You're doing a project, you look over, talk, they sniff in your face or like breathe in your face or something. Boom.
I can hide my off days. I can talk to myself and no one will see. When I just like feel really bummy, I'll just like put my mask on and then my hood up and then I can hide.
What are some of the ultimate cons?
My face is
Your face gets really itchy.
My face.
You can't communicate with people regularly.
My face sweaty. I gotta talk real loud.
Real loud.
Okay. To be honest, a lot of people, like, when they wear masks, like, some might not have masks, but...
I feel like some people look different.
Yeah, they look different without it.
Cons, can't breathe, sweating, and not being able to see beautiful people smile.
Well, I wear glasses, so they're always getting fogged up. It's kind of uncomfortable.
Cons, you can't breathe, you sweat like crazy because it's hot, especially where we live. And two, like you just don't get to see everyone's face.
Oh my god, when your face starts sweating.
Yeah. Backtracking and the way we interact with people. So because we have this thing like on our faces, it's not a real representation of how we would usually interact with people.
It's not as easy.
Enunciation is really difficult with masks. I think that's one of the cons of when you're presenting.
Not being able to read lips.
Exactly. That too, especially in a language class. You really rely on that.
Do you think masks are beneficial when it comes to presenting or when you're going to do the work in class?
I think it might help students feel more comfortable when they're presenting, but I think in the real world, hopefully when this is over, we won't necessarily have the mask, so it might do more harm than good.
I don't really have anxiety like that. I know some people are funny.
During presentations, you can just like cover your face, and if you want to cry during the presentation, you can't see it.
Well, I always do the assignments, so that's not really a problem for me.
I believe that indeed, wearing masks during presentations or whatever it may be is very important and beneficial because sometimes when you are presenting, you get nervous and maybe you pee your pants a little bit, maybe you get a little red.
I guess, hide my red cheeks.
Yeah, like when I'm a little shy.
So a lot of these issues can be very difficult, and one of the things that we're seeing right now is that we really want to be able to give people a chance to be able to listen to each other. Because the words that I said aren't as important as the listening that I do. So make sure they take time out to listen to somebody else, because that can generally make everything work out and acknowledge the struggles we all go through.
Wear your masks.
Yes.
That's all I'm asking.
Yes.
Love yes.
Go high tides.
Oh my god.
That was a great first segment for our first episode. Masks are just one of the new rules coming to our school. Why don't we learn about more of those?
Sound test, 1, 2. Say something.
Hello, I love cheese.
What's up, high tides? Welcome to a brand new season of Beachville News. This year promises to be a year like no other. Because, unlike last year, all of us are spending it here, in school. Therefore, new rules apply. Let's give you a rundown. First, high tides, the most important rule of all. Wear your mask at all times. Please, wear your mask from the second you walk into school to the second you walk out. Why? Well, COVID sucks.
Rule number two. Please make sure that starting on Wednesday, you wear your proper uniform, which includes a school...
Why aren't you wearing your uniform?
Shut up. A proper uniform includes a Miami Beach Senior High shirt or sweatshirt that could be either gray, red, or black, pants that aren't ripped, and shorts that aren't too short.
The third rule, social distancing. We're here in our beautiful cafeteria. And as you can see, on the benches, there are signs that say, do not sit here. And of course, don't sit on those seats. Listen, I know nobody respects those rules, neither do I. But now is the time to start doing it.
And additionally, please don't exit using the student parking lot if you don't have a vehicle. We don't want anyone being injured.
Anyway, High Tides, thanks for watching Beachville News. And make sure to adhere to all the rules. Please. I know I will.
Well, it's time for the last segment, as well as the most reoccurring segment, Second Opinion. Last week, we didn't have a question, but this week, we do. That question is, how do you feel about masks? Either scan that QR code, or check out the link in the description to answer that question. Now, Saturday was the 20th anniversary of 9/11. While none of us students were alive back then to remember, we still cannot forget what happened on that day. To end this episode, I would like to hope everyone has a great 2021-2022 school year. I'm Jed Hoffman. Bye.